with Kevin Brown, CTO for the IT division at Schneider Electric. Kevin, during your keynote at Data Center Dynamics, you talked about there being three different sorts of data centers. Can you just kind of talk through Schneider's view of the domain?
Yeah, I can, Damien. And a lot of this is about how do we start dealing with edge computing and what's the vocabulary that we use to talk about it. So in our view, we simplify this down to that in the future, there's really going to be three types of data centers: the centralized cloud, the regional edge, and then local edge data centers, which I think, you know, I like to talk about as yesterday's networking closets and server rooms now are going to need to be treated as data centers in this world of edge computing. And literally, if you're a typical enterprise, I mean, you may have thousands of these that you're responsible for managing.
So what particular challenges will the proliferation of these edge environments present?
Well, you know, I think when you have these edge environments, it's basically what were yesterday's network closets and server rooms. With the advent of edge computing, we believe that people are going to need to start thinking of those as data centers. So, you know, maybe 10 years ago, I had one or two centralized data centers, and what did I do? I had great security, I had great management, and I had control over what was happening. We now believe that, you know, when you have these thousands of data centers that are out there, these thousands of local edge data centers, you're going to need an effective way to manage them and ensure that they're secure.
And from a management point of view, how are they going to affect that?
Well, the our view is that the management tools that we've been using up until now really are going to be inadequate to go to the future. And because if you get into this very complex hybrid environment of I've got to manage my local edge data centers, my regional edge data centers, my applications that are in the cloud, it's going to demand a different approach. And we think that enabling these management tools to be into the cloud will help us with that and really augment the ability for our customers to be able to provide, again, the level of management, the resiliency, the security that they need across this whole hybrid environment.
You recently announced EcoStruxure. That plays into that automation space, does it?
Well, it does, because what EcoStruxure is really about is enabling our current platforms to work in the cloud, because we believe that a cloud-enabled management platform is what's going to be needed to deal with this very complex hybrid environment, thousands of local edge data centers, regional data centers, and applications in the cloud. You know, 10 years ago, we announced StructureWare. And StructureWare was a lot about how do we start integrating the building management system, the power management system, and the IT infrastructure management that we did into a single, you know, start integrating those together. And 10 years ago, about 10% of our customers were asking us for that. You know, today it's about 85% are asking. So we know people want integration, but it's not going to be enough with the future of what we see, and that we're going to need to be able to integrate it. And I also believe there's going to be a limitation in staff that has the ability to manage and correct what's happening in this complex hybrid environment. So a lot of the benefit of a cloud-enabled infrastructure is enabling our partners, ourselves, to augment the staff of our customers so that they can more effectively maintain all of these systems that they're going to be responsible for.
Is EcoStruxure just for companies that run Schneider Electric infrastructure equipment or products and services?
No, it's not. I mean, you know, we've worked very hard to make sure that it can be compatible with third-party devices. So at the connected product level, we can connect, obviously, Schneider equipment, but also third parties. And when you get into the edge control, what we call the edge control layer in apps and analytics, you know, we're going to hopefully put together a very robust set of applications that our customers are going to want and need. But however, we also recognize we may not be able to do everything. So we are working very hard at our cloud-based data lake to put in a standard API and some SDKs so that if a customer wants to be able to write their own applications, augment, integrate with something else, we'll make that as simple as a process as possible. And that's something that we're working on, and you'll see it roll out throughout 2018.
And if customers wanted to differentiate between StructureWare and EcoStruxure, how would they do that?
Well, I like to think about it as, again, StructureWare was about integrating, EcoStruxure is about enabling these platforms to get into the cloud, right, in a much more open IoT type approach. So it's really, EcoStruxure to me is the next logical evolution of what StructureWare was, but we really felt the need to put a different name around it because it is a much different way of thinking, much more open, much more cloud enabled, and really trying to address these challenges that we see the industry facing over the next 10 years. So, you know, we've increased the performance of data centers from an efficiency standpoint by 80% over the last 10 years. This is one of the tools we think we need to get another 80% increase in the next 10 years.